It is always a great honor to come and speak at Leadership Summit and participate in the panel discussion at here at RAI. And thanks to Kumar, Nagesh, Dr. Hitesh Bhatt for giving this opportunity to me. And I think the theme of this time in retail, what next, makes it slightly easy for me to speak first, because what next can be quite futuristic and there can be a lot of imagination, ideation also possible. Some things are already there in the pipeline, some things will happen. So coming straight, what next? In my view, whatever be the next, goods are still going to be the purpose of retail. So customers are going to look at retail for goods and services. So the eye of that cannot be taken off by any retailer. Customer service will always remain important. The ways in which goods and services will reach to the customer will evolve. As anything is evolving, retail journey is also evolving. The whole focus can be in terms of technology, in terms of services, in terms of interaction, engagement, towards improving ultimately the customer experience. So this should be the in the backdrop of the mind, what next, whatever be the next, we are trying to improve the customer experience. And in the process, whoever does it better will gain in terms of business. So for that, what all is happening? So there is online-offline convergence, which has been talked and which is happening in different ways. Different organizations are doing. Everybody is trying to do in their own way. Some were only offline, they are becoming online. Those were only online are now trying to become offline as well. So there is a convergence and omni-channel which is coming into the play. Even the smaller players who are just coming up are also ensuring that they have a physical presence and they try to bring in an online. So I think the core theme, one of the tracks, will be definitely the online-offline convergence and omni-channel, because customer will become used to asking all these things. If you are a retailer, if you just want to be in one small pocket, then it is possible. But if you want to grow and be the full experience provider, then online-offline has to be there. There will be the people who are wanting to touch and feel. So can only offline, which is the website and e-commerce work, the answer may not be there fully. So will the offline become redundant? The answer is no. Will online become redundant? The answer is no. So both have to be there. So the customers, especially in the Indian context, the customers will want to touch and feel and see and experience the new product. So for some time, there will be a need for handholding of the customers, and that sometime is till India is entirely covered. So there is what we are touching just now is the surface in the larger cities. But there is a large India which is in the tier 2, tier 3, tier 4 towns and beyond also. So all those people will have to come to the same level. Till that time, there is a growth opportunity for everybody to do in whatever they are doing. But they will have to keep doing it better and better towards this online-offline convergence. Now, when people are doing offline also, the experience, or those who are in offline situation, how can they give the same experience of giving an endless aisle to the customers? So there are solutions, and which will become much more prominent in terms of that there is a device which is there in the store. They don't keep the item, but they are showing it to the customer and taking it to the next level of offering what is not there, which they can arrange for the customer, and maybe the customer will wait for them and expect that I will come and pick up, or they will deliver to the customer. This kind of an experience will be quite a large chunk which will happen, and as it morphs from the original retail in India, What used to happen or even currently happens in a small electronics shop, the person, as I have seen from my childhood and all of us have seen, that the person in the small shop, the shopkeeper does not have all the items. He has just one representative refrigerator or one air conditioner or one small devices which are there, which he wants to show to the customer. And then as soon as the engagement starts, he takes out a catalog and shows to the customer that this is what I can all arrange from a distributor. He will make a phone call. Is this color available, that color available? This is the price. I can give you this discount. He's arranging all that. Now this will become more assisted with a technology which will be made available to them either by some service provider platform company, or they will themselves have their whatever methodology of showing it to the customer that I am giving you a more depth than what I myself have just now. Next question is that what next? So discounting, how long? This is everybody's guess. Finally, everybody is here to make money. So how long discounting will continue and people can buy sales, keep buying sales? And will the customers remain loyal? Tomorrow somebody else will do discounting and will they shift? So this is a subject which will evolve, and this is also going to be a very important part of what next. Stores which are there or malls which are there, will they become irrelevant because real estate prices are gone high? And what will happen? People will try to, you know, shrink it and be on the side. The answer may be no, because what has been seen is that people, especially in India, people are not that they want to sit in the house and just not go anywhere. There is a weekend for everybody. They want to go somewhere, look at things, enjoy things, meet, entertain. All of that probably will continue the way it is currently doing, and even better with more engagement and more better things. Tech upgrade and digital interventions are something which are a done thing. So in that, I think there are a lot of topics which Dr. Hitesh said, but and we all also are from the industry, so everyone knows. But just to list down, so virtual reality, augmented reality, assisted entire experience which is there, the larger players and even the smaller players will get technologies like we have seen virtual assistants. So Google Assist is there, similar to that, and Alexa we are seeing from Amazon. All of this will be made available on plug and play basis kind of things, and there will be service providers who will only give these kind of platforms. So anybody and everybody can ensure that they are connected with this kind of assistance to the customers. Voice-based searches will make life easy for the customers. So heart of all this will be a smart device which the customer will have, which is as simple as the smartphone of the customers. Those who are better off will have better devices like Jio Giga Fiber and all will come, set-top box will come, that will give a different interaction for the customer sitting at home. But the basic is the smartphone and the connectivity which will enable the customer to connect with all those who are wanting to offer them an improved digital service, which will be enabled by all these plug-and-play situations, virtual assistants, VR, AR, augmented reality. In the bigger stores, we will see humanoids which are there. There are some experiments which have happened abroad, and there is Sophia, which has been given a robot, which has been given a citizenship in one of the countries. So similar to that, these will all be democratized. These will become available to people. So whether on a physical humanoid or on a digital screen, there is greeting to the customer, there is personalization, and if not, within the device of the customer, which is the phone, all this will get enabled for the customers. Things like smart mirrors, smart trial rooms, endless aisles, as I said earlier also, self-checkout, scan and shop, by looking at the QR codes wherever on digital screen. These are all talked and done in small pockets. These will all become democratized, and as the things will become more and more popular, the cost will go down and it will become affordable for everybody, and somewhere it will become a necessity and a survival toolkit for all those who want to call themselves as a modern trade or be in the better off of the line. And once it is democratized, if you can download on an app and things like that, I think this will become a very low cost subject. For the convenience of the customers, things like subscription list, which are today done by some high-end people who have got data analytics, AI, etc., etc., these will all become very routine, that the customer is not looking at the mundane items. They are talking to their phone and saying, please book this, please book this. It is added to the list and the order goes to whoever is their service retailer or the larger retailer or the smaller retailer. There will be a lot of delivery jobs which will come in the play because, as I said, that the customer will have to be reached the goods if it is an offline service. So there has to be a connect with the customer somewhere physical, which is important. So delivery, now this delivery can take shape of, there are crowdsourcing scenarios where people will connect, they will be only available. Now they are serving anybody and everybody, they are empaneled, authorized, and whoever, it is fastest finger first kind of a thing, that whoever gets them into the order, they are in the locality, on the bike, on the cycle, on the nearby locality, walkable locality, and they will get the order, they will pick up and deliver from the nearest place. So this all crowdsourcing of the delivery piece can get democratized very soon is a possibility. Regarding the in-store experience and in the mall experiences, there are these other technologies which I may list for the completeness of the subject. The beacons which are sensing the customers all around, there is tracking of the customers with the permission of the customers, various apps right now also track the customers. All this will become an order of the day. When you are passing by the nearest store, the, you will get messages, notifications, coupons, etc. This all will become, today it is niche to a few people who have invested in technology or who are having access and are having a passion to do that or are progressive. This all will become a very routine subject in the time to come. Video analytics and same way surveillance in terms of the efficiency of understanding the demographics, understanding the customer's behavior pattern, sensing, all this is talked, we read it, see it, but these are all technologies which are now proven technologies, only a matter of coming down in terms of cost and becoming available to everybody. Along with this, the customer's behavior in terms of asking for coupons, thinking about offers, etc., which currently is also the behavior which anybody goes to the store, they will ask, what is the offer, what is it, what will I get? This all will become a routine behavior in terms of looking into your device and connecting with the shop digitally and looking for the coupons, or there will be coupon aggregation platforms which will be giving you all of this. This is all there right now, but this will become a mass scale phenomena in the time to come. Other technologies around improving the efficiencies for the retailer, the large retailers, in terms of the supply chain optimization of warehouse operations with robotics. Today, very few people are having finger picking capability. There is all in experiment. The moving of material to men is happening and final picking. This all will become enabled with finger picking robotics as soon as that becomes a reality, which is already Boston Group and a lot of other people are doing that. So this, once that happens, there will be a shift in the way warehouses are managed and the entire supply chain logistics is happening. Route optimization, cost optimization, today few progressive people are doing. Probably this will become also a very plug and play situation. Like everybody today sees Google Maps and when they step out of the house and look at the route at which they are going, this will become for retailers also a routine, that how am I sending the goods, what is happening, and I am optimizing the cost on that. There can be a phenomena which we are seeing today of the rise of, again, the small shops. So are the small shops going to be completely wiped out? We see in smaller pockets everywhere that people who are the small medical shops or the kiranas, they are, suddenly you see a very well lit up shop and it's all white, everything. They've also put in the signages, things like that. So there will be a next generation of those kirana shop or the small shop owners or the apparel small shops, electronic shops, who will become progressive and will embrace pieces of the modern trade which they will want to bring in for their customers. This is their survival. They will also possibly on a cloud platform provided by some service provider, only a platform which will be plug and play, that I am creating my local ecosystem where it is a small 25, 30 buildings which are nearby and is connecting, or there'll be a big aggregator who will do all of this for them and enable all of that. is possible. Payment instruments, currently also all of them are there. Every time we are seeing newer instruments and newer ways of making payment, heart of it, UPI today. But again, NFC and tap and go, and all this will become better, that probably as we are seeing that you don't even need to do anything of checkout once your transaction is completed on a scan and shop basis, or self-checkout is done. The payment is just done as a done thing. You don't have to do anything. Just walk off after the last button of the transaction is completed. That makes life easy for you. There is also an important reference which we must learn from the food industry, which is currently happening and which can become. So the product will probably be available in terms of making by anybody, even small entrepreneur, anybody is making, he can make a good visual of what they have. And like in Zomato or any food app today, you see, you read the name of the food service restaurant, you don't even know where it is, but you see a very attractive menu list actually. Where is the kitchen? What is happening? But you see a good name. Okay, some biryani, something, something, pizza, Italian, etc. Probably if you like the taste, you're ordering and you don't even bother where is the restaurant or where is it coming from. Similar to this, products can be made by people and they will put on different platforms. So that class of entrepreneurs who are manufacturing in a small way, getting ability to sell it throughout and creating their own niche and brand can also become a very big thing that will again become a crowd thing which is there. Price and product comparison. I think people will have to come on a platform where they will have to show their prices, because otherwise customers are having a lot of options to understand the price and they will always go to the lowest price. And so as we have internationally in many places that the price is very transparently available in situations. So in different industries, these kind of things will happen. Where niche products and unique products are there, it may not happen. But where there is electronics and things like that, price comparison will become an essential necessity if you are to be there. You can't just say, come to me and I will tell you afterwards. Maybe customers will not give you that chance. The means of marketing, obviously there is a dominance of Facebook, Instagram and Google on that. How that will evolve, and some, you know, people will plug into that. And as I said, this small ecosystem of your own connected people, today people are small shops are doing, or retailers are also doing, trying to do with WhatsApp and those kind of reaching. But the larger platforms will continue to support, and they will become better in terms of offering more and more, analytics straight away for those who are using their services in terms of lookalike customers, and also enabling those who are engaging those services as business accounts to reach out to the target audience customers in a better way. So that is on that. Own analytics, yes, AI and machine learning and all of that, larger retailers will do, smaller ones will plug into somebody else, and that is there. So I think I have said a lot and tried to cover the entire landscape. There are the session which is going to take in detail a lot of things. I will just like to still sum up is that ultimately whatever happens for a retailer, cash is the king. There is cashback is the king also trying to become, cashback is trying to become the king. But ultimately, I think in my view, what will take over is that the customer will be willing to pay the price for the convenience. Whoever offers the most convenience to the customer will forget that extra amount which they are paying for the convenience. And just the last thing I want to say for today is that goods still have to reach to the customer. Whatever you do online, offline, sitting at in your conference room and technology, ultimately, if you don't know how to deliver the goods to the customer at the right price, it will be the survival of those who are the fittest in the long and medium term. Thank you.